Hey everybody, this is your start to finish guide about using negative keywords in the Google Ads interface. My name is Adam Markfeld. I'm the owner of Paracore. We're a pay-per-click lead generation agency in Phoenix, Arizona. And today I'm gonna be talking about negative keywords in Google Ads. I will start as I always do, just in the docs, just to talk about the concept sort of generally. And then we're gonna move over to an ad account and we're gonna go through how to find search terms, add them as negative keywords into your account and what the different types of negatives are that we're gonna be using. All right, so I always like to start with the docs here just to explain the concepts. So if you've looked at my keyword videos, broad match, phrase match, and exact match, or if you know how keywords work in general, you have similar choices on the negative side. However, it's important to know that Google treats negative keyword matching much differently than it treats the positive keyword matching. So when you add a broad match keyword in as a keyword that you want to target, it gets very broad and loose and Google interprets it very loosely. However, when you add a broad match keyword in as a negative, it's not nearly as broad and loose. And I'm going to talk about that here in a second. But you can add negatives as broad, phrase, and exact match. They just behave differently. So it's really important to know that they behave differently. All right, so if you're adding a negative as a broad match, this is the default. They give an example here. So if for negative broad match keywords, you add won't show if the search contains all of your negative key terms. So if the search contains all of the key terms, even if they're in a different order, then the negative broad match will prohibit that search from showing. However, your ad will show if the search contains only some of your keywords. So basically this is saying, if you put in some keywords as a negative and they're broad, and the person searches and all of those keywords are in the search, even if they're in different order, it will block the search. So for example, if your negative broad is running shoes, and you add that in, I'm going to show you how to add it in a second, and someone types in blue tennis shoes, your ad could potentially show because it does not include running. If they type in running shoe, it will potentially show because in the negatives, Google actually makes a distinction between shoe and shoes for a broad, which to me is very crazy. When you look at broad match on the positive side, Google takes insane liberties in how it interprets that. But on the negatives, it's very, very, very strict and much more narrow. So adding in running shoes will, running shoe as a search will not actually prevent an ad if you have running shoes as negative. So you have to put in running shoes and running shoe if you want to exclude both of those. Blue running shoes, both these words, plural, are in there. So that'll block an ad. Shoes running, different order, same words, that'll block an ad. And then running shoes, the exact search will block the ad. That's broad match. Just remember on broad match, your ads will show even if they are singular, even if there's a difference between singular and plural. So if you're adding those in, you have to add singular and plural if you don't want running shoes. Phrase match is kind of more like how phrase match used to be. Now phrase match is kind of more like modified broad. For negative phrase match, your ad won't show if the search contains the exact keyword terms in the same order. This is the important piece here, in the same order. Now with broad, it's even if the terms are in a different order, that's the distinction. Here, the distinction is in the same order. So the search may include additional words, but the ad won't show as long as all the keyword terms are included in the search in the same order. So using our same example, we have running shoes as quotes. Blue tennis shoes, both words are not in there. Running shoe, both words are not in there because of the plural piece. Blue running shoes, even though you have blue before it, you have these two keywords, your negative, that's in phrase match, in the same order. So it's gonna block the ad. Shoes running, same words, different order. That's the difference between broad and phrase. And then running shoes, that will block because it's the exact same search. Finally, we have negative exact match. Oh, by the way, phrase match uses these quotes right here to make sure it indicates phrase match. Broad match, there's no notation around the words. I'll show you this in a minute. And then exact match is here, it has brackets. So exact match, for the negative exact match keywords, your ad won't show if the search term contains the exact same keywords in the same order without extra words. So this is like literally exactly this search term, block it. So we use brackets to distinguish exact match. So you have the open quote here and the open bracket, close bracket, running shoes. So blue tennis shoes, not the same words, the ad will show. Running shoe, the ad will show because shoes and shoe are different pluralities, singular versus plural. don't know if pluralities is the right word there, but single versus plural, blue running shoes. This will show too, because you have blue before it. This has to be the exact match. Shoes running, different order, will show. The only search that will block, that will be blocked by this negative is running shoes, the exact match. I also want to note that you can use three symbols. I think this is important to know in your negatives, ampersand, this accent mark and an asterisk. The reason is if you have cafe and cafe with this, with these are treated differently. These are different keywords. And then socks and shoes with the ampersand and then and shoes here, those are different as well. So if you see socks and shoes, you may just want to add in socks, ampersand shoes and vice versa. Same thing with singular versus plural. You just want to proactively do that if you see those coming into play. Okay, so let's jump into an ad account. This is an ad account that we've looked at before. And this is a account that I believe this one is our broad match campaign. So there's like a lot of fuzzy searches going on here. So, you know, just bear with me, but I want to show you kind of how this goes. So if you're in your campaign, you can click this guy to open and close your window here. But you're going to go to your keywords, and then you're going to go to search terms. These are your keywords if you're actually adding the keyword, when you're adding keywords. So we're doing some broad here, and I have another video that talks about why we do broad match keywords. We didn't used to, but now we do. They tend to perform quite well. But here are the search terms. So here we see this is the search term. This is what someone searched for. They searched for this. The match type is broad. I'm not going to get into this, but this is basically like, how did the search term match with the keyword? Kind of beyond the scope of this video. And is it excluded as a negative? So this is a company, this is a business, and they are already excluded as a negative. So you can see that this is excluded. Ad group, and then the keyword here. This is the keyword that actually triggered the search. So if we want to add window as a negative, which I would recommend, we're going to click here. There's a couple different ways to do it, but the way we're going to do it is we're just going to add it right to the ad group. So we're going to do add as a negative. If you actually like this keyword, you can add as a keyword, but we're going to do add as a negative. And you can add it to the ad group or the campaign. So for example here, I'm going to add it to the campaign because really for the entire campaign, I don't think it needs to be there. And I want it to only restrict if someone just types in the word window. Because if they type in window replacement, I want my ads to show. This is a window and window and door company. They do replacement windows and doors. So if they just type a window, I don't want it to show. However, if I did this, the broad negative, that means that if this keyword shows anywhere in the search, it's going to block it. I don't want that. And even if I do this, and this kind of doesn't make sense with only one word because it's the exact order, phrase match enforces an order. This doesn't really make sense, but this is going to act the same as the broad, right? Because basically it's saying if window appears anywhere in the search, block it. If window appears anywhere in the search in this order, which is just one keyword, block it. But what we're saying here is we're saying if window appears just on its own, then block it. So I'm going to add this. I'm going to save it in the campaign. So now I've excluded window. So now window, if someone just types in window, our ads will never show again. And that's how you really clean up traffic in your ads, in your ad accounts. This is one of the very first things we look at. If you're running broad in particular and you're not doing negatives, your campaign's probably going to perform suffer quite greatly. But even if you're doing other types of campaigns, you need to be looking at negatives. We do this multiple times per week for each account. We'll do one with two words. So here's black windows. So one of the reasons we kind of keep some of these open is like this one right here, like Elenco windows. You know, that converted. And we have a pretty strong cost per lead on this campaign. But black windows, so if we want to add this one, we can do, all right, I want to do black windows. And let's say like we just don't even sell black windows. Let's say that our business does not sell black windows at all. So if I add this, oops, I don't want to do that one as a negative. I want to add it to the campaign. So if I just do this, which is the exact match, which is what Google defaults to, just if someone searches black windows, it's not going to show. So it's going to block our ads, which is good. We don't want our ads to show. However, let's say like we just don't sell black windows at all. We might just want to add it this way. We would hit save. So like if someone typed in black windows replacement, it would not show, even though we replace windows and doors. If they typed in black windows replacement cost. And remember, black window and black windows is different. So, or we could do phrase, which enforces the order. So We can choose either one of those two based on what we're trying to achieve. Now, you do want to be careful with phrase match and broad match in particular, because you may be blocking search terms that you weren't thinking of or expecting. You only use these two when you're really certain that it's not what you want, right? When you're really certain that you don't actually want this word or this, like a lot of times, a really good negative is like job, right? So like, let's say you have like electrician or something like that. And let's say you're buying the keyword electrician. You don't want to have the word job. Like people might search electrician job, electrician jobs. Job is a good one, plural. Or, you know, review might be one potentially you don't want. There's, you know, blog might be one. If it's like some sort of a category where people are researching, looking for blogs, there are kind of general, these are really good types of negatives for like striking out an entire category of searches. You know, anything related to employment, anything related to, not anything related to research, but like research-based stuff like blog. Now you might want it, but they're really good ones to potentially exclude. So that is how you add negatives. Now, in order to see the negatives that you added to the campaign, you can actually, we'll do cancel here. I'm not gonna add that one. We'll go to negative keywords. And we actually use quite a few lists, which I'm gonna go over in a separate video. I'm gonna film a video about that right now. But here you can see Windows, the one I just added, and it's added at the campaign level. Now, if I wanted, so that means that all of these ad groups, all three of these ad groups now have the negative window associated with them. So if I go into one of these, let's say I go into new windows, and I go into negative keywords, I'm gonna see window here added at the campaign level. Now, if I change this, actually, I'm just gonna delete it. I'm gonna remove. Okay, just to show you. And then I go to, where am I going? Oh, I wanna go to, well, I wanna go to ad groups here. Just ad groups. And then I go to window installation, and let's say I do negatives, and I add a keyword here, window, and I wanna do the exact match. Okay, so now we're in window installation. You can see non-geo broad window installation ad group level. So if I go over to this campaign and then I go to ad groups and I was in window installation, now I go to window companies and then I go to negative keywords, I don't actually see that negative in here. It's only applying to that one ad group. So that's really important to know, right? It's really important to know that where you're adding it. Are you adding it to the, are you adding it to the campaign or to the ad group? And it just depends on what you're trying to achieve. We will often add it to the campaign, but we will often add it just to ad groups. But actually we pretty much exclusively use lists. So this is really how we manage our negatives. So that is, that's the overview on negative keywords. So if you have any questions, please leave in the comments below. Please like the video if it was helpful to you. Subscribe and you'll be notified whenever I post new videos. I do about 3 a week. And hit me up with a comment if you have any questions or need anything. Thanks for watching. See you next video.